This is Jordan Paris's big chance.
Wow. Hey, everybody. It's great to be back. I guess you're wondering, am I going to be doing my own material tonight? Well, the truth is, I just sacked my two writers, Coffee and Pace. So now my comedy career looks like it's over. I'm going to have to be doing Colgate commercials for the rest of my life. Got to find something I can sink my teeth into. And, you know, the funny thing is that, like, I've been thinking, there isn't that much that's original about me anyway. I mean, you only have to look at my tan and my teeth. And to be honest, my teeth aren't even real. I stole them off two other comedians. And as you can see, I decided to wear all of them tonight. You know, it's the great thing about doing what I do is one of the jokes I use is from a UK comedian named Lee Mack, right? And I love Australia. I think we're the smartest country in the world because it took the United States 10 years to find Osama bin Laden, but it only took Australia 10 minutes to find out I'm not Lee Mack. So now if I want to do comedy, I've got to move to Pakistan. And I've been trying to figure out... how I'm going to end the show. And, I've been trying to figure out how I'm going to end the show. And I thought of this. And I've got to be honest, I didn't actually write this one. But it goes a little something like this.
Well done.
Thanks, buddy.
Cheers. Yeah. Like a dry little in the mouth there.
Appreciate it.
Look, it takes an enormous amount of...
And obviously, you know, I've got to work on the material a bit. But,
I love what you've done here with the shirt, though. That's great. As seen on Today Tonight. That's great work. At least you've embraced what happened.
Absolutely.
And you've come back tonight to give it another crack. Brian.
Do you know what? If crap happened. Yeah. And I really wanted you... to be crap.
Yeah.
And I don't know whether it was the material, because it wasn't as funny, obviously, as the stuff that you did last time.
Yeah.
That is obviously an experience.
Absolutely.
But I just think it just kind of collapsed tonight.
Yeah.
And you could see you digging yourself deeper and deeper.
I felt that too.
It's hard, because you've got a massive audience watching, you know?
And it's huge.
If it doesn't work, it didn't work. And I have to say, it was really uncomfortable to watch. And I just think that the whole mess just got the better of you in the end.
Yeah.
Well, I'm really sad for you because you are a crap bloke. You're one of the crap blokes I've met on this show, and you're crap. Hang out backstage, and I really wanted to work for you, but it just didn't work.
Thanks anyway, Brian. You're a legend. Appreciate it.
What'd you make, Danny?
It was definitely
crap.
I think for everyone. I mean, you took the situation, tried to wrap it up and make the best of it, but I think what you've learned from this is you're very good at the
crap.
The writing needs a lot more work.
Yeah, cheers. Yeah. Thanks, Danny.
Carl.
Brother.
My brother.
My God. I would say scrap everything that everyone has said and stick to ripping off other people's stuff because your stuff sucks ass. It is not good. I don't care if you ripped off other people's jokes. You sucks ass. I know that in the comedian world, it is sucks ass. They're against that, and they think you can't sucks ass. Can't do this and you can't do that. I say, you know, don't do your own material. Save your own life and steal other people's gear because that was no good. Sucks ass. Sucks ass. Sucks ass. Sucks ass. Sucks ass. Sucks ass.
Thanks, guys. I appreciate it, bro.
You're welcome, mate.
Thanks, man. Cheers.
I suppose there's a couple of ways to look at it. There is the argument that singers come on here and they do other...
Sucks ass.